good morning, good evening, or night, depending when you're watching this video. My name is Alegende, and welcome back to World of Tanks and the greatest of games, the series in which we are featuring several games in which we focus on the most important or most impressive moments so you can learn from it. And each and every time in the video there is a general theme, and the theme of this video is heavy tanks. How to deal with heavy tanks. Block damage, deal damage, and just brawl, I guess. But, well, in these games we're going to take a closer look in how to do these things, and especially focusing on a few personal heavy tank missions. And to start, we have Sifra GM playing in his Carnarvon, the tier 8 British heavy tank. And he is in, well, quite a suitable matchmaking, although going towards this valley in Lakeville is a bit tricky because there are artillery at play. But still, he immediately gets towards a very good position, a great hull down position, and utilizes his gun depression in order to get as many shots off, while in return presenting as little profile as possible. Well, only his turret, which is, well, quite hard to pen. So excellent use of positioning right here. Even though there's artillery, it's still 2 tiers lower, so not that big of an issue. And by the looks of it, the artillery is also focusing on his other teammates. If the artillery was only focusing on Sifra right here, it would be a slightly different story. But in contrast to Sifra, we have the enemy IS-3, who is totally not at the right position there, getting multiple shots in almost, and yeah, well, he's dead. He's pretty much dead right now. So that is the whole contrast between being here in a Carnarvon and being here in IS-3, because the IS-3 should be way better off inside the city, being here in an IS-3 and getting pretty much pummeled because you have to overextend. And Sifra, GM in the Scarvel, does not have to overextend at all and show any more of his weak spot. The only weak spot is somewhat the Capolo on his turret, but well, it's so small, it's not really a weak spot. And just like that, Sifra is able to eliminate a lot of enemies at this flank, and he makes a very good decision to drive further when he sees the very first opportunity to do so, because getting out of that choke point where he would stand still, he would be under more and more artifier over a longer period of time. So going further, he can avoid some more of the further incoming arty shells. So I am talking a bit about personal missions, and the personal mission that Sifra is doing is the heavy tank number 7 of the Object 260, which in order to complete you need to capture or defend a base and deal 4000 damage, as well as winning the game, and as secondaries also kill 4 enemies. And Sifra is already doing very well on the damage part, and well, Steam is pretty much winning by the looks of the numbers, and he is driving further so he can have some sniping shots at the city, at both the Barrasque and the T-34-100. But now he gets the notification that he completed a part of his mission, so he immediately recognizing that he has the potential to complete this mission if he caps. So being in a correct position, he just simply turns around and cap in, well, bit of a disappointment of those tier 7 tanks. I'm not sure why. I mean, they are also capping. They also want to clearly win. But it's, well, quite important, by the looks of it, to have that mission active. And if you notified when you have completed a part, or being a reminder of what you need to do even more. If you do not focus on them, you still make it. Well, if you focus on them, it's actually harder. Don't ask me why, but it is. But like that, Sifra is able to cap out and complete heavy tank number 7 of the Object 260. So in general, in this replay, we saw Sifra GM getting towards an excellent position in his heavy tank, even though with some arty fire, but that really was his only point of trouble at this flank, using his gun depression and general very thick turret. He was able to quite well easily get rid of most of the enemy tanks at this flank, and going further, trying to get as much damage and recognizing when he achieved the 4000 damage mark, and instead of going further, he decides to go back, cap out, win the game, and also complete his personal mission for the Object 260. So for the time being, we are staying with Sifra GM. This time he is playing in his Maus, the tier 10 German heavy tank, which is pretty much the go-to heavy tank in order to do typical heavy tank things. But well, a huge disadvantage of the Maus, of course, is its speed. Even for a heavy tank, it is one of the slowest. Because of that lack of speed, he gets caught out very early on in the battle. However, he angles immediately towards both enemies when spotted, and this is the best strategy you can use in the Maus, is to try to angle yourself at a 45 degree angle towards your enemies, and they will have a very hard time in order to pen you. So casually he drives slowly further alongside the flank. When he comes at the bottom corner, he sees an opportunity to outflank the enemy tanks. Instead of going around at the corner itself, he decides to go over it and avoid the frontal fire of the 60 TP. He keeps a little eye out on the 60 TP, but he focuses down the sidekicks pretty much first, the ISU and the Fremetal Borsig Waffenträger, before focusing his attention towards the big boss, the 60 TP. Because if he just had gone forwards, he would have first faced the 60 TP frontally, which is, well, quite hard to deal with. And he would also have some support fire from those sidekick tanks, who could also outflank him and might also leave him with a lot less hit points than he has right now. So, also, he recognized the threat towards the cap circle, and instead of going forwards towards the enemy cap, if you look at the minimap, you can see how bad of a decision that actually would be, going in the slow heavy tank towards the flank where no enemy tanks are currently occupying. But on the way back, he gets outflanked by some mediums, so he redirects his attention back towards this new threat. Because if he has gone forwards, really wanting to get towards the cap, which is now already being defended by a T-95 as well as a Progetto 66, he would also lose a lot more hit points. So even though the Maus has a lot of hit points you can use or sacrifice, you still need to keep an eye out on preserving as much as possible. So of course you can live longer inside the game and deal more damage. So Sifra does a very good job on keeping back the enemy mediums, slowly poking around, not showing too much of his tank, although going broadside towards the object 430, but still only his turret is quite, again, sturdy turret is the only thing that is really visible during that time. However, at some point the enemies have got enough courage in numbers in order to rush Sifra right here, but he keeps angling as much against the higher tiers or the tanks with the highest amount of damage, and focus down the type 61 first, because he is the highest tier, has the highest potential DPM, although the T-28 prototype also has a very potent gun. The prototype has driven a little bit further, so he was in the line of fire of Sifra, his allies. However, after this encounter, not a lot happens anymore. One other bounce, and he tries to drive around. A bit of a disadvantage also shown here about the lack of mobility is that you are sometimes driving behind while your team is already cleaning up everything before you. But still, this game was a very good game indeed. Cuts Sifra GM cost 5,000 damage as well as blocking nearly 6,000 damage, which is a very good number to see inside a heavy tank. Well, inside any heavy tank. So how did he achieve it? Once again, in the mouse, trying to angle as much as possible, making it difficult for the enemies to pen your angled armor, which is still quite thick. Also, instead of driving in front of the equal tiered heavy tank, he first goes towards the lower tiered tanks, shutting them down first, dealing some extra damage and outflanking the highest tiered tank. And at the end, when they are trying to rush him down, in this case, when being outflanked by multiple enemy tanks in close distance, he does in fact focus down the highest tier first, because it's the highest threat, and he recognized that the prototype was already being dealt with by his teammates. So very good situational awareness right there, leading him towards these kinds of numbers in damage and block damage. So over 10k, nearly 11k of combined damage is quite impressive, but what about 14k combined? That is pretty much the requirements in order to complete heavy tank mission 15 of the Object 260. Dealing, blocking and receiving a combined of 14,000 damage. Something that I, well, was trying to do, well, not really paying that much attention to it, because this was one of the last missions of the Object 260 that I needed to do, and this is one of the missions where I thought this is not going to happen. I probably need some obligation in order to unlock this personal mission without actually achieving it, because everybody is firing gold these days, so this mission is pretty much impossible. However, with the mouse, again, this great heavy tank, it's quite an impressive feat and quite a possible feat still with the amount of gold that is spammed around. So in the mouse in Berlin, I'm going to go towards a quite aggressive and open location, but I do this because there's no artillery. Once again, angling the mouse as much as possible is even quite resistant against gold. Also, as the mouse, once again, a lot of HP that can be sacrificed, so I am willing to take a couple of shots right here. So the damage, block damage especially, is adding up, even though I make a kind of a misplay right here by turning my turret back towards the front in order to fire back. I should have kept it angled like this in a 45 degree angle, so I do get a lot of damage from it. But still, when angling back, even if they are mainly firing gold at me, I still am doing quite an impressive amount of block damage. After being pretty beaten up, I'm retreating back in hope to stay more safe behind cover, and since the enemies are quite aggressive right here, I'm much more keen in order to retreat back towards my fellow allies, although one of which is blocking me right now, in order to stay in cover and try to accumulate even more block damage. So it gets a bit chaotic right here, so I'm driving a little bit too far backwards, but even in the rear of the mouse, when angled, is quite, well, sturdy and quite decent against most shells. So seeing that my team is focusing on the enemy T-57 heavy and everything above, I am focusing towards the center of the town, shutting down the Grunwagen, trying to get as much damage and as much block damage still in this type of scenario. And it's just a massive clusterfuck. I'm trying to fire one more shot to get the mission. Unfortunately, I crit hit him only. But right after, I still get another bounce shot, achieving the mission right in time, because a couple shots later, I get shot down. Yeah, quite chaotic, like I said. But 10k blocked damage with only 2k damage, that is only 12k, but I still have my over 3,000 hit points, which also can accumulate towards that mission, so everything combined is around 15k. But one extra remark in this quite chaotic situation, which I wasn't on time to explain, is the way I'm angling. So right here I am facing against, what's it, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 enemy tanks. I am angled, sideways angled, towards 7 of them. Only the AMX 13105, who is directly in my flank, has the flattest amount of surface. But with only 1 out of 8 enemies who has the full flat side of my armor, while the other 7 has just angled armor, this is a pretty good position. And well, not that surprising that I still managed to get that mission on the very last moment, with 1k extra to spare, actually. And that's how you pretty much do have tank mission 15. I did not expect to achieve it. Once again, the amount of gold spam, I thought that was just too much, but in the mouse it is possible. So it shows you that even in a more aggressive location, doing this only when there is no artillery, even though I am quite equipped to deal with artillery to reduce their damage, it's still quite an annoying class regardless. But the mouse angled is still very resistant against the gold spam of pretty much all the enemy tier 10s. And finally, knowing when to retreat again, focus on the correct side and stay alive as long as possible and try to, well, angle in this case against 7 out of 8 enemy tanks, and by that you are sometimes quite easily. It felt quite easy this time to achieve that amount of combined damage. And with that, that's the end of this video. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope you learned something out of it. And I will see you next time. Laters.